Finally, we need to make some assumptions in order to use one-way ANOVA. The first is normality. All the populations from which the samples are from are normally distributed. Another is homogeneity of variance. The data come from populations that have equal amounts of variability. And finally, independence of observations. The results found from one sample won't affect the others. However, we can violate these assumptions under certain conditions. We can violate the normality assumption if the sample size is large. We can violate the homogeneity of variance assumption if all the samples have nearly equal sample sizes and the ratio of any two variances does not exceed 4. We have to maintain independence of observations, but we can use random assignment to conditions to help us meet this assumption. Let's do a quick summary of ANOVA to wrap up this lesson. I'm not actually going to wrap this time though. We're just going to wrap up the lesson. If we have 3 or more samples and we want to know if any 2 of them are significantly different, we look at both the between group variability and the within group variability. Between group variability is a measure of how spaced apart these sample means are from each other. And we do that by finding the grand mean and each squared deviation from the grand mean for each sample mean. We multiply each sample size by the squared deviation of each sample mean from the grand mean. Then we add them up. Then we have to look at the within group variability, which is essentially the squared deviation of each value in each sample from the respective sample mean. So we add up all sums of squares from the respective sample mean. And then we have to find the average sum of squares for each by dividing by the degrees of freedom. In the case of the between groups, this is the number of samples minus 1. And for within groups, this is the total number of values minus the number of groups. This is the same as adding the degrees of freedom for each group. There we have our F statistic. And if it falls out here in the critical region, past the F critical value, we'll reject the null. After making a statistical decision, we can use the multiple comparison test, one of which is Tukey's honestly significant difference, which is a value that if any 2 sample means have a difference greater than that value, they're considered honestly significantly different. You've also learned how to determine what proportion of the difference between means is due to the independent variable. That's eta squared. And that's a wrap.